Now, students, we are going to see the graph between velocity or displacement. Okay, now we are going to see, but before seeing the graph between velocity and displacement, let me see the graph of ellipse. What is the graph of ellipse? This is the basically equation of ellipse. Okay, how we make the graph? So like this is like this way. Okay, this is A, which is the interception on x-axis. This length is A and this length is B. Okay, this is the graph of ellipse. Now we are going to see the graph of velocity and displacement. So what is the relation between velocity and displacement? That is, as we saw in previous lecture, that is omega under root A square minus y square. A is amplitude, means maximum displacement, omega is angular velocity, and y is displacement any time t. Okay, now this we can write like this: v by omega is equal to under root a square minus y square. Now further squaring both sides, we are getting v square omega square is equal to a square minus y square. This come on this side. Y square is equal to a square. A we can write 1 into a square, and a square is coming downside here in division. Here it is in multiply, so it will here it will come in division. So what we get? One. Now if I am compare it with this, so this, and one more thing I forget. A square is coming on both sides now. So which one is big? A omega is more. So this, if I am supposed taking B and here I am taking Y. So A omega is more. So this ellipse is making like this. Okay. This is what A omega. And this is what A. Okay. This is what A omega. And this is what A. Now further, we are going to see the graph between acceleration and displacement. Acceleration, suppose that I am representing by capital A, or displacement Y. So what is the relation between A and it? So A is equal to minus omega square Y. So here I am writing like this. Okay. So look. So when Y is negative, we'll say acceleration. When y is negative, acceleration is positive. It means acceleration starts from here. Here y is negative, here minus y, so acceleration is positive. Now when y is positive, acceleration is negative. So like this graph. Okay, or we compare with the equation y is equal to minus mx. So we are getting same, m work is done by omega. Okay, this is the graph of acceleration and displacement. This is the maximum displacement, A. Here we are getting maximum acceleration, but in negative direction, minus A. It is the maximum displacement in negative direction, means minus A. And here it is the maximum acceleration, but in positive direction. Okay. Now we'll see the graph between acceleration or velocity. So look, velocity is equal to omega under root a square minus y square. So now we have to find the relation between velocity and acceleration. So look, what we get the relation between y and acceleration? So a is equal to minus omega square y. So at the place of y, we can write minus a omega square here. So we are going to write at the place of y minus a omega square. So here a square minus a omega square, because y square is there. So okay. Here again v by omega, here a square minus a square omega power 4, and squaring both sides, we are getting v square omega square is equal to a square minus a square omega power 4. This I am taking this side, omega square plus 4. This we can write 1 into a square, and this a square coming downside, so this become okay. Now again, which one is big? So acceleration is more than velocity, so here acceleration we'll write here velocity. So again the graph is like this. If we compare this graph with x square by a square and y square by b square is equal to 1. Okay, so here b square is equal to a square omega 4, means b is equal to what? A omega square. So this is acceleration, maximum acceleration, and here a omega is maximum velocity. Okay, now further we are going to see, now further we will see energy of oscillator. Okay, so this we'll see too much easy way. Okay, and you have to use little bit your mind. So look, suppose that I am taking a simple oscillator, means simple pendulum. Now you will tell me, if I am talking about this, so this is the reference lines. Okay, at this line, when I am displacing this bob here to here and releasing the bob from here, so here this bob having maximum but potential energy. Okay, it means here kinetic energy is zero, but if we talk about here, so here from this reference lines I am taking height, so here particle having no height, it has only kinetic energy, and here again this kinetic energy is going to change totally into potential energy. So if why I am talking, so here it has only potential energy, no kinetic energy, because here at last point velocity is zero. Again when it's going backside, so potential energy decreases, and here potential energy is zero, then again kinetic energy is maximum, then again it's going this way, kinetic energy is going to be here zero, and here maximum potential energy. So look, if somebody asks me what is the total energy of a oscillator, so total energy is sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy. So if I am saying total energy here, so total energy is always constant, because energy is neither created nor destroyed. It is the sum of potential and kinetic energy. If we say here, so whatever is the energy here is total energy. And total energy is here what? Kinetic plus potential. So at lowest point, if I am saying at lowest point, if I am going to find total energy, so total energy is at every point is same. Okay. So at lowest point, potential energy is zero. What is kinetic energy? Half m v max square. Because at this point velocity is maximum. Okay, what is Vmax? So Vmax, remember, Vmax is a omega. Okay, from previous lecture we know that Vmax is a omega. Now I am going to write here. So what is total energy? Total energy is half m a square omega square. Okay, now if I want to, it is a total energy. Okay, this we'll use very frequently. Okay, now if I want to know only kinetic energy, but at any position y, okay, so look, kinetic energy at any position y, kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. So remember the position and v relation, v is equal to omega under root a square minus y square. I am going to put here. Okay, so what we get, the kinetic energy at position y, half m as usual, v square means omega square, and this become a square minus y square. Okay, this is the formula of kinetic energy at any position y. Now if somebody asks me, I want potential and I want kinetic energy at any time t. So it means it want kinetic energy in terms of time. So how we can find, sir? We don't know, sir. So look, y is equal to what? Remember, a sine omega t. I'm going to put here. Okay, so what we get? Kinetic energy at any time t, half m omega square a square minus a square sine square omega t. A square I'm taking outside. So kinetic energy half m omega square a square. This side become 1 minus sine square omega t. And 1 minus sine square omega t is cos square omega t. Is what? Cos square omega t. So what is the kinetic energy in terms of t? Half m omega square a square cos square omega t. This is the kinetic energy in terms of t, and this previous formula kinetic energy in terms of y. Okay. Now again, if somebody asks me what is the average kinetic energy average. So remember, this is what? This is total energy, remember? Okay, but leave that. Actually, we are always taking the average of cos theta or cos square theta or sine theta or sine square theta. The cos square omega t having average 1 by 2, you must remember. So when we put the value of cos square omega t 1 by 2 or sine square omega t both having value 1 by 2. When I put here, so I am getting 1 by 2, 1 by 2 means 1 by 4. This is the average kinetic energy. Or we can also say 1 by 2 into half m omega square or a square. This is basically total energy of oscillator. So we can also say average kinetic energy is half of the total energy, E total. Okay. Now we are going to see about the potential energy. Now, what is potential energy? So look, at any point, if at suppose that I want the formula of potential energy. Okay, potential energy at any position means at any y. Okay, so look, at any y, kinetic energy plus potential energy sum is always remain constant, that is total energy. Okay, so kinetic energy plus potential energy, what is the formula of total energy? Half m a square omega square. What is the formula of kinetic energy at any position y? This is the formula. I'm going to put half m omega square a square minus y square. Potential energy is equal to half m a square omega square. Now I'm going to open this. So what I'm getting? Half m omega square a square minus half m omega square y square plus potential energy is equal to half m a square omega square. Now look, this and this, when I am taking this plus on this side, so that is cancelled. Okay, when I am taking this negative on that side, then potential energy formula at any position y become half m omega square y square. This is the formula at any position y, but I want the formula at any time t. Okay, I want the formula of potential energy at any time t. Potential energy of simple oscillator at any time t. So what is the formula of potential energy? Half m omega square y square. So remember, y is equal to what? A sine omega t. Can I put here? So why, what I am getting the relation between the potential energy at any time t? A square sine square omega t. Okay, this is the potential energy at any time t. Now again, they want average potential energy. So average potential energy is what? So remember, sine square omega t is what? Average of sine square omega t is half. So again, at the place of this, when we are putting half, so it's become 1 by 4 m omega square a square. So again we can write this potential energy average is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 m omega square a square. So this is what, this is the total energy of oscillator. So we can write potential energy average is E total by 2. Okay, this is all about the energy. Further we will study in next lecture. Revise each lecture, okay, whenever you have time, you have now sufficient time, okay. And if you have any doubt in lectures also, you can also ask me at my WhatsApp number, okay, then I will clear. Okay, bye bye, take care.